Toy Story Land, Green Army Man is out, Alien Swirling Saucers only 5 minutes. Toy Story Mania, 20 minutes. We had a Fast Pass for an hour, but I just checked and moved it up for now. So headed on Fast Pass today. I haven't gone through this queue yet. Since it's been in the new Toy Story Land, I've never gone on. So I don't know if it's any different. Oh yeah, this is. Oh, look at this. This is our first time seeing this. Look how cute. It said a 20 minute wait, but it's legit a walk on. All right, Bradley wanted to come on with me, and I don't let anyone win, so I said let the best man win, right? All right, let's see. Let me see that shoe in. Good job. Who won? Who won?
Me.
Oh, good job. You know I love my walls. And then in the gift shop right outside Toy Story Mania is a Buzz Lightyear wall. Alright, Slinky Dog Dash is a 40 minute wait. We're gonna attempt it even though I think it's a million degrees out. Of course, have to stop in one man's dream to see our main man.
We're in Disney World, so you don't need to see it.
It's all redone in here. Got some comics. Got a little store because you can meet Mike and Sully here. Galaxy's Edge.
Happy birthday.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Took away our benches though.
That is.
So we always gotta do one man's dream because we never know if it's gonna last. I'll be very, 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 very upset if it doesn't, but you never know.
You never know.
Cause even sometimes when we come, it's just like previews for movies and that gets me really mad. Like if you wanna do previews of movies, do that in soundstage where Drew Carey is to be.
Oh, I know.
Ugh. I used to hate Drew Carey show. That I was very happy left. It was the worst. But I think we're heading to Muppets now because Bradley acts every 5 seconds if we're going to Muppets. So I think that's what we're doing now. The show we hear about constantly. Time for the Muppets.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, while we're a captive audience, a display of tremendous tap dancing talent with the added cultural component of a pot of flowers balanced on my head. Get up, Rusty.
Yeah! I'm waiting for everyone to enter, but Bradley's patiently waiting for the show to start. He knows exactly where to look. It starts right there. He knows. He's waiting.
Who's up there?
Hey, look! Look at the guy in the goofy mask! That's not a mask. Ooh. Sorry, lady!
Over there.
What a cute idiot.
Get you, old fool. We're both into the sea.
What do you want to tell her?
I'm thinking.
You want to bring me on Jimmy Fallon?
Is that your new favorite ride?
But that's not here.
That's your new favorite? All right.
All right, your turn. Go! Go!
They have a photo pass person at the outside car. Waiting for our sci-fi res.
You could sit with Dota.
So we got front row car. Our reservation was 7:45, but we tried to check in earlier and it was about 7:10 when we checked in. And they were like, oh yeah, we can't guarantee that you'll get in earlier, but like you can put your name in and like you might get the table and not the car seat. We really like the car seats. We're like, alright, like we're really hungry though, so we'll take what we can get. But we didn't expect to be called, so I went like on a search to get like a pretzel, and as I was about to place my order, they called saying that they called us, aka 5 minutes after. So I thought we were gonna get a table, but we ended up still getting a car. So win-win. Get to eat earlier and get the car still. But I have to sit by myself and not talk to anyone. Anymore as an appetizer, but they still have it as a side dish. She mentioned it, so we still got it as our usual appetizer that we always get. And then I got the wings.
This is Mom's jam. We came to sci-fi just to listen to this.
Beware of the blonde.
But why aren't they showing? The blonde?
Thank you. I got a chocolate milkshake to go. How was your dinner?
It was good. I had the turkey sandwich. So it was on a multi-grain croissant with a avocado aioli sauce and french fries. And it was very good. For, fresh turkey, so just a plus. So I enjoyed it.
And they gave her a birthday treat.
And I got my birthday cupcake.
How was your dinner?
Yum.
Did you like that restaurant?
I want another ride.
Oh, another ride?
Did you like that restaurant? Was it fun?
Yeah. Come here.
It was good. I had the buffalo salad.
Good salad.
It's a salad. I got the beef and blue burger, and I don't really like this restaurant to begin with. I just go because mother loves it. I got the same exact burger. Like, literally everything was exactly the same at NBC, and I thought NBC's was much better than here. This was really messy. It was just like falling apart as I was eating it, and it didn't have as much flavor as the one at NBC, but it was still juicy, so I'll give that. But there wasn't much flavor besides the actual blue cheese on the burger.
So started with the buffalo wings, and it's just straight up the chicken tenders with buffalo sauce on it. So it was all right, nothing crazy. Sauce was okay. And then I got a bacon burger, bacon barbecue burger, just a normal burger. Something you get at like a Chili's, whatever is equivalent to your type of place like that. So it's not bad, it's nothing spectacular. So, like, I ate it.
You're paying for the ambiance there.
Yeah, my mom just loves that place so much, so we go for her. Food-wise, it's just like a normal Chili's, Ruby Tuesdays, fried, whatever you have.
But you can't see your food.
And yeah, that creeps me out.
Yeah, and I don't like going to, I don't like eating in the dark, even in my own house.
Me
like,
too.
If we're like eating on the couch and—
No, I have to have every light on.
All the lights have to be on in order for me to eat.
Me too.
And I cook the food myself, so you have no idea what you're eating there, so.
That is very true.
You have to be very trusting.
Yes. And I got a milkshake, and she was like, oh, you wanted to go? I was like, yeah, because we're gonna walk around. She's like, good answer, because the cup that you get in the milkshake,
the glass,
she's like, when you pour that in, it only ends up being a kid's size, but when they give you a to-go, they give you a full cup. Like, I only ate a quarter of it, and I'm already like, ugh.
And we got Bradley's ice cream. This was Bradley's ice cream sundae that came with his meal. You get two sides, so we got mashed potatoes and the ice cream sundae, and this whole thing was filled with ice cream, so yeah, because we wanted it to go.
So to go is the way to go.
And our waitress was really awesome. I really liked her. Sorry,
yeah,
I did not catch her name, but
she was very good.
Yeah, very attentive.
Yeah,
we liked her.
Yeah, so it's an experience that you can't get anywhere else. That's the whole thing. That's why I like that kind of stuff, because well, I love primetime. Like, that's my favorite meal. Like, their fried chicken is the most delicious thing in the entire world. But once again, like, my family sometimes doesn't want to go there, but it's like an experience. Like, you're not gonna get that anywhere else. So that's like sci-fi. You're not gonna get that anywhere else.
No.
So it's all about that.
But it's a one and done for me. We've experienced
one and done. Yeah, we do it every 2 years
because Mom needs to go. Mom, but are you happy that you went there?
I love
it. She loves it.
Okay.
Then that's all that matters because it was her birthday dinner. So.
Yeah.
Mine.
But Brown Derby's my choice of places to eat here.
No, she loves it. And it's not bad. It's just like your average Chili. Like,
and
so like.
They say the burgers are delicious. So I just didn't get a burger.
Yeah, the burger was good. Like, it was a burger. Like, it's not like it's a bad meal there. It's just. It's not like out of this world amazing, but it's not bad.
And you'll see my button on every day because it's my birthday vacation.
It is.
So I get this every day.
But this meal was legit the one thing she was like, I want to go eat at Sci-Fi. And it was the one place I could not get reservations for.
You never can.
I tried so hard and then finally I got it. And then I lost it at one point. I was freaking out and then I got it again. So that's why it was like kind of like 7:45 is on the late side for us.
Yeah.
But you take what you can get. But we got in 45 minutes early anyway. But that was like I could have gotten California Grill. Like, every other restaurant was open except Sci-Fi. So.
So it's very popular.
It is. It's an experience.
It's been around. They go, ah. Wow, you got a better spin than I do. Come on.
And just like that, another day has come to an end. Start of the day was boring as hell. I didn't do anything. I'm really bummed about it. I tried to let the housekeeping clean and I was waiting around, and I went to the gym, and then it was just like me waiting for her to get done, and then by the time she did come in, I felt like by the time I would get into Universal, I would have to come back, so didn't do anything this morning, so I was bored, so I gotta make sure tomorrow I'm out and ready to go. But then Hollywood Studios was good. Got on Millennium Falcon in 25 minutes. Dad got to be the pilot, Dad and Mom. We crashed a lot. But that was cool. Bradley had a blast on that. Got on that really fast. Got on Slinky Dog as my first time. That took about probably 40 minutes. That line is just killer because it's just straight up in the heat. You're like under things, but it's hot. I just dripping the entire time. So that's not fun line to wait on. I probably would never wait again for it. It's a fun kids coaster. I would say more thrilling than like a Barnstormer kind of coaster, but so it's like more enjoyable for adults as well, but it's just too hot to wait for. Dinner was filling, very filling. Always enjoy watching the sci-fi movies, and it's Mom's favorite. And not sure what the day will bring us for tomorrow. As always, never know. But Bradley's gonna come in here and we're gonna hang out for a bit. And then it's off to bed. So, with that, I say goodnight, everyone!